the shocking murder case, turning the world's attention back to violence against women. Sarah Everard was simply walking home in London back in March when a police officer brutally raped and killed her. Now, despite demands for change, the femicide consensus tracking project says around 80 more women have been killed by men in the UK ever since Everard's murder. And other cases from around the world have highlighted calls for racial and social justice as well. Joining me now are Jamie Klingler, co-founder of the British grassroots campaign Reclaim These Streets, and Yogita Bayana, who leads the group People Against Rapes in India. Welcome both of you to the show. And before we talk about what's transpiring right now in the UK, let's talk about this from a global perspective, because according to the UN, at least 30% of women aged 15 and older have experienced violence or sexual violence. This does not even include sexual harassment. That's an entirely different element. Fewer than 40% of women who experience violence seek out help of any sort. Let me begin with you, Jamie. Is this a moment of reckoning, in your opinion, not only in the UK, and I would argue even in the US with the Gabby Petito murder, but around the world?
We continually say that it's a day of reckoning when one of these horror cases happens. But 6 months ago was the day of reckoning, and nothing has happened. Nothing materially has changed in those 6 months to make us safer on our streets in the UK.
And so, Yogita, you know, at the same time, these are both two white women, and we have to address that because this is happening not only to white women, but women of color around the world. And in India, there is an epidemic of violence against women there as well. Tell us the latest figures, because they are just jaw-dropping.
They are not, unfortunately, Bianna, jaw-dropping, because as per the NCRB, National Crime Report Bureau of India, there is a decline in the crime against women, which is a complete denial by the government. Because I have been, working on the field for last so many years, and for every day we are poured in with calls, helpline is fully loaded. Still, when we get to hear that there is a decline by the government, they are in denial mode, first of all. But in 2021, there were 25,331 reported cases of crime against women. In 2019, there were 43,783 cases. There is a one-year gap, but as per the data, there is a decline. But ask us, we are working on the grassroots level. There is definitely an epidemic. And these are reported cases, mind you. And so many cases go unreported. Reason? Because 80 to 90% of the violence against women happen within the four walls of the house. So there is a social pressure not to report such crimes. They really don't come out even to report. And I don't want to even get into the details what happened to the reported cases. How many of us, we struggle every day to get the cases reported, and even after getting registered, there is no sign of justice. I mean, it's so slow. The system is so slow. I was appalled to hear what happened to Sarah, and I can very much relate to what happens to the women in our country also, irrespective of the color. It is happening globally, and I'm so sorry to hear the state.
And not only with respect to women of color, but in regards to India, women of castes.
Absolutely. You're so right. There is a gender-based violence, then there is a caste-based violence, and the people with the so-called upper-lower caste, there is so much difference. Here's a lot of vulnerability attached to the lower caste. So of late, we have seen so many cases which we are seeing, which are coming onto the surface, especially the case which happened last year where the girl was raped and burnt by the police. I mean, imagine the authorities were involved, like in UK case, this gentleman was a police. I would say there the police to be blamed. Here I feel very sad that in this particular case, this cop will get away with life sentence. There is no provision for capital punishment there. I don't know, but we are pushing here in India a lot.
And Jamie, it is that Sarah Everard was murdered at the hands of the police that really sent shockwaves, though, throughout the country, and months of fear among women who were told to stay indoors and fear for what may happen to them, until obviously it was identified that she was in fact murdered by a police officer. You know, the Met Police released some advice for women, which has been criticized, and I would ask you if you think it's right to be criticized. Basically, they're asking women to ask plainclothes officers questions like, where are your colleagues? Ask to speak to an operator on police radio. If you believe that you are in a real and imminent danger, seek assistance. Shouting out to a passerby, running into a house, knocking on a door, wave a bus sign down, call 999. I mean, I guess in theory, this is good advice, but is it practical if somebody is approached by a police officer, and in the case of Sarah Everard, she was immediately handcuffed, what more can women do?
He also had a valid badge. So if she had called an operator and said, is this the police officer who is apprehending me? They would have said yes. It's absolutely asinine, especially telling you to get a bus, to get a bus driver to stop. Like, you're in a busy, busy metropolitan center. Like, that's never, ever going to happen. And instead of the Metropolitan Police taking responsibility for not vetting their cops and really working through why Wayne Cousins was able to indecently expose himself to people and get away with it and stay on the force, they're telling us to double vet police officers in case an undercover officer stops us. If an undercover officer put me in cuffs, I'd be so shocked and so terrified. Like, the idea that I would then run or try to scream and get help, it's just absolutely not okay. And women of color or people of color trying to resist arrest gets them killed.
And is it helpful then to know that you have people at the very top suggest that this was just one bad apple?
Oh, we're furious about that. And it's a way of not taking accountability for every step of it. They also threatened to arrest me and my colleagues when we tried to put on a vigil for Sarah Everard using the same legislation that Wayne Cousins used to arrest and kill her.
And let's not forget about the murder of Sabina Nessa as well in the UK. Yogita, I'm just wondering, as you are watching from your perspective, what the reaction is in the UK. How are women absorbing this in particular in India? Are they having these types of robust conversations about the need for a change?
Absolutely. Right now, I was hearing you, Bianna, that you were mentioning about how women should reach out to the helpline number, which number she should dial. It's a high time. We should talk to the right audience here, which is men. It is all about the mindset. I think the focus should be telling the men what not to be done rather than telling the women how to protect themselves. So we also now working on a lot of prevention plans and advocacy, as I said. So what we are planning to do is we are planning to reach out to the boys, young boys and men, and tell them that if you do this, this is your legal repercussion and your end. Otherwise, also, we are working very discreetly on the mindset, social fabric of our country, because it's so deep rooted. And we talk to men. So we have called this campaign called We Men. So we will tell the men to behave rather than telling women to protect themselves. So, I mean, we have to shift the focus from women to men, and talking about gender sensitization, gender equality, empowering women to the men.